Seguimos en CTIA Wireless 2011 y esta vez nos visita una empresa que se llama Mavenir y tenemos con nosotros a su presidente y Chief Operating Officer, que se llama Pardeep Kohli. Y vamos a cambiar al inglés como siempre para seguir la conversación. Pardeep, welcome to Telesemana TV.
Thank you.
So tell us who Mavenir is, just for those in our audience that might have not heard in Latin America from the company. We hope they have, but just in case.
So Mavenir is a five-year-old company focused on mobile infrastructure. What we do is we enable carriers to provide all IP services, like for example you have seen Skype and other things. So we enable a carrier to do what companies like Skype do in their own network, using their own numbering system, using their own back-end offices, their own provisioning systems. So carrier can then compete with all these new service providers like Google and Skype and make sure it preserves its value.
Okay, so now that you mentioned that, because this is a very hot topic obviously, why operators have not been able so far to compete with these guys? Or why these guys, let's put it the other way around, have been able to compete with the operators? And don't tell me because they don't use Mavenir's infrastructure.
So I think if you look at most of these new guys, Skype and all, they succeeded more in the wireline world when the internet was there and all these devices, laptops and everything had internet. They have not done much yet in the wireless space.
But they are starting to.
But they're starting to. So this is where there's a turning point for a carrier that they could actually lose out the way they lost in wireline if they're not careful. There are certain advantages which a carrier has today that Skypes and those guys they do not have. First of all, carriers own the relationship with the subscriber.
Like the billing.
The billing, and also you buy the handset, they subsidize the handset and all that stuff. The other thing is in like Skype and all those, they're close communities. For example, if I'm talking to you, then I need to have a Skype ID and you need to have a Skype ID and somehow we need to communicate. Versus a carrier, they provide interoperability, the phone works all over the place, they make it simple for a subscriber to do. So what we are doing is, we are not saying we'll do exactly what Skype does, but we will do it in the way...
That's Skype call?
No, it's actually a mobile call, I should have turned it off. I think that the key thing is if a subscriber can do everything which Skype does, but using the same number, using the same address book, and there's no software to be loaded, you don't need a separate ID, and it works the way it works today for a wireless phone, then it's a lot simpler to use. And we are actually enabling that.
Okay. Right?
And so in my view, the battle is just now starting in the wireless space, and if carriers are smart enough, which they are, they will find a way to compete in the wireless space.
Okay, now tell us a little bit of the mechanics of your platform. I mean, I'm an operator, I'm listening to this, I want to use Mavenir, I want to protect myself against these guys, or at least I want to be able to compete. Do they need to put in place hardware, software? How long does it take?
So we provide a complete system with software and hardware. It actually goes in data centers. So we are providing Skype does, or like a cloud. But that cloud could be owned by the operator, right? So it could go into operator data centers the way their billing systems are and other systems in the data centers are. So these are servers, you can put it in three places, provide you complete fault tolerance and a distributed environment. And the way I try to communicate with the carriers is that if you look at Apple, they were not there 5 years ago.
No.
They all came and they changed the whole world very fast,
seconds.
Right?
Yeah.
The same thing, and this is the first time in the history of the wireless where a handset is smarter than the network. Because normally network was smart and the handset was very dumb with only 10 digits in it.
Do we need to change that?
So now, I think we have to change the network because otherwise, everything will go to the other guys and carrier will just become a pipe.
Okay.
So what we do is we provide a platform which actually integrates with the telecom world. It provides the same reliability, but it also has all the IT infrastructure so that it can fit into the IT world. So it can talk to Facebook, it can talk to Skype, it can talk to all the new world,
right,
but also can coexist in the existing world. So we are the way we look at Mavenir is it's a bridge between the legacy world and the new world, and we can help an operator catch up with all these new Web 2.0 communication services but in their own way, okay. And provide a complete service to the consumer. So we are, you know, one of a kind. We compete with all the big guys. So the way we see it is, you know, the way Apple came and changed the scheme.
That's right.
We could change it for all the network vendors, right? And so we could provide a platform which could help them get there faster.
Okay. A month ago, we were at Mobile World Congress and we were discussing with some web providers like Skype. They were here in our studio.
Right.
And you know, they said we are not competing with the operators. We actually want to bring value to them by partnering with them. Sort of. I mean, probably they hear this, but they might say it's not accurate, but that's what I understood. So I don't know if when you're saying that, is there a possibility of making these guys cooperate instead of compete? And does Mavenir would allow an operator to associate itself with Skype, for example, in a way that they can both win?
I think you know, today carriers make over 80% of their revenue from voice and messaging business,
yeah.
Right? And the maybe next 20% come from data access. So if somebody comes to your house and says, "I'll give you a service better than you," which replaces 80% of your revenue, to me it's like a Trojan horse, because what they're really doing is they already have a branding in the wireline space. And they are trying to use that branding to get onto the wireless. The wireless carriers are branding in the wireless space. So if the wireless carriers invite them and get into their house,
yeah.
I think they're just like that's calling defeat and just becoming a pipe. And it did happen. If you look at a lot of wireline carriers disappeared, and they became either just a pure DSL provider, or they're not providing any more service than just a bandwidth and pipe.
Yeah.
And maybe there's a business model like LightSquared, for example, which can only wholesale, you know, radio access and good quality wireless access. And if a carrier wants to have that business model, then it's a different business model.
Okay.
But if you're providing an end-to-end service, then you need to compete it for that service. And so my view would be, you know, you need to know who your friends and who your enemies are, and they are your enemy at this point. Yeah.
Let's go for Latin America.
Right.
Are you doing any work in Latin America? Given that, I'm assuming that for what you're saying, that you're kind of a new company, or not? What is your
history? We are a five-year-old company, but I personally have experience in Latin America. I mean, in the past worked with companies like Telefonica and America Mobile, and so we are, you know, approaching them. You know, if you know, the transition to next generation started in U.S. first,
yeah.
And it's going to Europe. But it's also now going to pick up in Latin America. Maybe it's a year behind, and we are now working with you know, a couple of carriers more as a trial basis, which we cannot announce in Latin America. And so I think we'll take our experience from here and expand it to Latin America.
Okay, what is your message in terms of the competitive advantage of your platform versus other better known, I would say, companies like, I don't know, Ascension or all these guys? So what is your message in terms of, you know, you need to trust us now?
Well, I mean, I would say look at, I keep giving the example of Google and Apple. You know, they had 0% market share and it changed. So in this world, right, the market share doesn't mean anything, because in every time there's a discontinuity, players change. You know, when there was a 2G world, GSM, there were like 7 or 8 players. There was Lucent, Motorola, Siemens, Nortel,
yeah.
And all of them are gone, right? And I think the next generation happens
with services,
with the service providers, and maybe, you know, consolidations, and as you're seeing in US. But look at the vendors as well. You know, big vendors are good at selling boxes in volumes. So they're good at building base stations and coverage and radio. But they're not good at doing customizations and flexibility and being nimble,
okay.
Right? And what we are is a, I guess, a vendor which is nimble, flexible, and as I said, we bridge between the telecom and the IT world. And that's the difference. And if you want to compete with somebody who can keep up with the smartness on the handset and provide you the same level of flexibility as the Web 2.0 guys have,
yep.
Then you need to start looking at vendors differently. And it's a new world, you know, just do not assume the past has any value, because it doesn't matter anymore.